have you hanging on. We'll go right to the phone calls. The number to dial, 888-ASK-HANK. First up, Josh. He's listening in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, on the web. Hi, Josh.
Hey, Hank. How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
So my question is, a lot of my atheist friends always bring up a point where they say, you were born in a religion. So because you were born into that religion, that's the one that you believe. And then they bring up a hypothetical statement saying that, if there was a person in another religion, that's not the one that you believe in, and they die, and let's say that they don't end up getting to know God and Jesus' love, and how would God deal with them?
Yeah, well, good question, actually. First of all, there's an article in the Christian Research Journal, speaking of the journal, it was a few journals back, but it dealt with this very issue, which is that this idea that's being posited by your friend confuses the causal origin of one's belief with the entirely independent question of whether those beliefs are true. So whether you live in Saudi Arabia or whether you live in America, whether you live in Iran or whether you live in Russia, you still have to determine whether what you are hearing, what you have in terms of your background, really corresponds to reality. And the fact of the matter is, Paul actually argues that this is not all that hard to do. Because you can look at the sun, moon, and stars, whether you're in Russia or America, and recognize that there's a sun, moon, star maker. So the whole issue of a creator is settled by what you see with your naked eye. Not only that, but God has written upon the canvas of your consciousness. In other words, he has writ large on your heart, there is a God. That's why I sometimes say there are no atheists in foxholes. And if you respond to light, you will receive light. We've never argued that it is the absence of truth that damns. We've always argued that it is the despising of truth that damns. And the reason we argue that way is this is how Jesus argued. Jesus said to Nicodemus, light came into darkness. Men loved darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. So Jesus is saying, the problem is not that there's not light. The problem is men don't want light. Pascal said this in a very pithy way. He said, God dwells in enough obscurity, so if you don't want to find him, you won't. He dwells in enough light, so if you do want to find him, you will. So there is no excuse. I mean, you can't say, you know, I grew up in a culture in which mathematics was taught, and therefore I am now indoctrinated by mathematics. Well, you still have to determine whether 2 plus 2 equals 4, regardless of what culture you grew up in. You still have to discern what is true and what is false. We are held accountable for what we know.